Hey everyone, welcome back to Odds Jam. Jared here, just bringing to you some information regarding the college football top 10. A lot of shakeups yesterday. I want to give a quick preview, quick overreactions, and a little dive into the futures market of the top 10 teams and who is sitting where. So first, let's start off by going over to Odds Jam. This is what I do every day. I take a peek at the arbitrage, the positive EV bets to see if there's any opportunities that I could take advantage of. So this is getting filmed Sunday afternoon, so the 4 o'clock games are just over halftime. We have one game left tonight. We have a baseball game left tonight, and then it's looking into a new week starting tomorrow. So I'll be looking for a couple opportunities tonight still to cap off the end of the week and go from there. As you can see, there is an arbitrage opportunity with Pinnacle and or DraftKings and FoxBet with Patrick Mahomes over or under 2.5 touchdowns. Good value there. I'm sure that's a positive EV bet as well. Yeah, right there, positive EV on that. Pinnacle has the over at minus 140. Over at DraftKings and FoxBet, you can get it at plus 105. So tremendous value there, a good bet for Sunday night to finish out the Sunday strong. I'll be taking advantage of that. Also down here, it looks like Yordan Alvarez for the Astros should be at plus 227. To hit a home run over at FanDuel, but it's at plus 290. So a lot of value there, almost 3-1 on that. So there's a good value. You got two bets you can put in later tonight to finish off the week strong. So like I said at the beginning, I want to cover a little overreaction and analysis from the AP poll top 10 that got released this afternoon for college football. So I'm just going to break down the top 10 teams, give you what they have remaining on the schedule and their chances to get into the college playoff. So, as you can see, all of the futures odds are right here. Georgia leading the way, followed by Alabama, Ohio State, and Oklahoma. Those are the top four teams right now. Crazy how Alabama can still be plus 220 after they just lost. Obviously, they have a chance to battle back in, play Georgia in the SEC championship game, and potentially win that and get into the college football playoff. Outside of that, I'm surprised they only dropped to number five. I thought they would drop a little bit further. Due to the fact they lost to an unranked team. So I'll run you through the rankings right now. Coming in at number one, Georgia, most dominant team in college football. That defense is insanely good. And a team like Alabama is going to be, it's going to be tough to score on that Georgia defense after we just saw them perform this weekend. So Georgia is the clear and obvious favorite at plus 125 heading into the week. I don't see anybody arguing that right now. Ranked number two, Iowa. So being a Big Ten guy, the Iowa Hawkeyes are ranked at number two. You can see their odds down a little bit lower. That's because they do have, they're going to have to play in the Big Ten championship game. They're going to face an Ohio State, a Michigan, a Michigan State, a Penn State. One of those four teams is going to get in there. They're going to have to face that team and beat them. Coming to number three, Cincinnati. Everybody loves Cincinnati. This team is looking awesome and very fun. They're sitting at plus 2,500 to win it all. Fun team to watch. So we'll see how they do. Coming in at number four, Oklahoma. Crazy game against Texas. Still undefeated. Looked rough. New quarterback, it looks like. So I'll dive into that a little bit further in the remaining schedule. And then rounding out the rest of the five, we got Alabama at five, Ohio State at six, Penn State at seven, Michigan at eight, Oregon at nine, and Michigan State at 10. So looking ahead, Georgia, the number one team outside of the championship game of the SEC, if they do run the table, they have to go to Florida, who's the 20th team in the country. They're going to have to play at Florida. I don't see them falling here. Seems like this team's the best in the country. They should win that one, but that's about their only test outside of the SEC championship game, and who knows who they'll be playing right now since Alabama did lose yesterday. Number two, Iowa. They only have at Nebraska left as the only competitive game I see them having on the schedule outside of the Big Ten Championship. As I stated, they will have to face a Michigan, Michigan State, Penn State, or Ohio State. I'll get into those four teams and where I see them finishing. But Iowa will have to go to Nebraska. Nebraska's been a tough place to play. Michigan played there yesterday, and that was a pretty close game. So that's their only test left on the schedule outside of the Big Ten Championship. Cincinnati is going to have to play SMU at home, who's ranked 23. I don't see them having an issue here as they are very dominant in the teams that they're getting matched up again. They are beating them and beating them at ease. So I don't see them slipping up. Depending on how everybody else fares by taking each other out, we'll see what happens in the SEC. We'll see what happens in the Big Ten. They should get into the college football playoff. And sitting at plus 2,500, there is a little bit of value there. Coming in at number four, Oklahoma. They have a tough schedule left. They have a very tough schedule. They have to go to Baylor. Baylor's been a very competitive team this year. They have to go to Oklahoma State. And as you know, that's a crazy rivalry, Oklahoma versus Oklahoma State. Oklahoma State, very good this year. And then they'll have to win the Big 12 championship, who will be Oklahoma State, Baylor, or the rematch with Texas. So they have three. If they beat Baylor and they beat Oklahoma State and then they head to the championship, they have three really hard games left. So if they can run through those three, I see no problems of them getting in. Even if they slip up, maybe lose to Oklahoma State, maybe losing the Big 12 championship, they still have a chance to get in. And at number five, Alabama. Wow, that was crazy what happened yesterday. We haven't seen Alabama lose a game like that in a long time, so it was kind of nice to see. But they still have a path to get into the college football playoff. They have to play Arkansas, and then they go to Auburn for the Iron Bowl. I mean, if they can win those two games, they should be in the SEC championship facing off with Georgia. If they lose to Georgia, I don't see them getting in. They lost to an unranked Texas A&M team who has lost back-to-back games before that. If they play Georgia and lose, I just don't see a two-loss team getting in, one of those losses being unranked. So I think they have to beat Georgia, and if they do, those teams will both get in, but I think they have to beat Georgia to get in. Coming in at number six, Ohio State. This is getting into the fun of the Big Ten. Are these teams going to eat each other alive so none of them get in? So then it's Georgia, Alabama, Oklahoma, and Cincinnati? Or is one team going to take control of this the crazy conference that's about to take place and assert some dominance? So Ohio State is going to have Penn State and Michigan State at home, and then they're going to have to go to Michigan. Then if they do win all of those, they'll have the Big Ten championship game most likely against Iowa, which is four unbelievable games left. Four top 10 teams they potentially have left on their schedule. That leads me right into Penn State. Penn State at number seven, they have to go to Ohio State, play Michigan at home, and then go to Michigan State. Again, if they can win out, they will win the Big Ten. They will face Iowa in the rematch that we just saw this weekend. Another team with potentially four top 10 matchups left on the schedule. And I've already talked about it a lot. Number eight is Michigan. They have to go out to MSU. They have to play Penn State at home and Ohio State at home. Same thing as I said about Ohio State and Penn State. They're going to just have to play each other. I mean, whoever wins out of all those games is going to potentially make it to the college football playoff. In between all the madness there, we have Oregon at number nine. They did have that loss earlier this year to Stanford, so I think it will be a tough path for them to get in. I don't see them losing a non-ranked conference game and still getting in a conference that's kind of weak this year. They will have to go to UCLA, who fell off, and they will potentially have the Pac-12 championship against Arizona State, a team that has looked a lot better, but Oregon's going to need absolute chaos, I believe, to happen in front of them for them to sneak in. Rounding out the top 10 is Michigan State, my team, who I am rooting for this year. They will be going to Michigan on Halloween weekend, or I'm sorry, Michigan will be coming to them on Halloween weekend. They'll be going to Ohio State, and then they'll be playing Penn State at home to finish out the season. I already said this for this is the fourth time I'm going to talk about it. Whoever wins out of those four teams, when they all play each other, they all play each other still. That team will go play Iowa, and then those two teams will play for what I assume to be a spot in the college football playoff. So really excited to see what's going to take place there. As you can see, Clemson is up there. Arizona State is up there. Notre Dame's kind of sneaking around as well. But here are the current odds. I would say if you're looking for some value, if you're looking for a team to maybe sneak in and do some damage, I got to say the Big Ten is where some value's at. Iowa sitting at plus 2,000 undefeated. Michigan's been looking good. Michigan State, Penn State, or Ohio State. They're at plus 800, so a little bit higher. They do have that one loss to Oregon. But all these other teams are going to just battle through each other. So maybe a Michigan State at plus 3,000 or plus 6,000 has some value. I still think Cincinnati at plus 2,500 has some value to that. If they do make it, you're going to have to pray that Georgia maybe faces an Alabama in the first round and one of those two teams take, you know, each other out. I would hope that I would say that Georgia needs to get eliminated first if anybody else in the country wants a chance. Alabama might be the only team that can compete with them and potentially take them down. So I don't see value at plus 125 too many things can happen for a team at plus 125 to win it all. So, like I said, if I had to put some money down today, I would go with Cincinnati, Michigan, and Michigan State. Yes, I'm being a homer, but I see some real value there as the Big Ten is going to eat each other alive, and I think it should be a good finish to the season. So there's a little overreaction, a little update on the current AP top 10 as we head into another week of college football next week. Excited for these next couple weeks to take place as the rankings are really going to fall into place. So hope you enjoyed this video. Thanks.